Welcome to Tokyo Fashion Express. I'm Marie. What do you think? As you know, this is a traditional Japanese kimono. It was made by a designer with a 40-year career who continues to challenge the status quo. Her name is Hisayo Shito. The kimono looks simple, but you'll soon learn there are a lot of hidden tricks and ideas. Let's meet the designer who calls herself a maverick in the kimono world.
Japanese kimono culture boasts a history of over 1,000 years. Today, one designer is carrying on the tradition, but not without redefining the kimono in contemporary times. The designer's name is Hisayo Shito. She's a modern maverick in pursuit of groundbreaking kimono designs.
I like the way maverick sounds. Makes me happy.
Shito believes kimonos can be embraced as everyday clothes, not mere icons of ancient tradition.
I've always thought of kimonos as fashion. But many people don't view them that way. Even Japanese people only wear them for special events, like weddings and other formal occasions. And that makes it difficult to call them fashion items, which I think is a bit sad.
Conventional kimonos are often adorned with flowers and varied scenes from nature. And typically, one kimono is made from a single roll of fabric. But Shito's works are not bound by these rules. Her designs call for multiple types of fabrics sewn together in creative assortments. Fabric meets fabric to produce riveting lines that attract attention even from a distance. The kimono blends right into the contemporary landscape. Next, there's Shito's bell motif. The designer has affixed a small bell, symbolic of the brand, to the garment with the hope it'll bring happiness to the wearer. In the traditional kimono world, metal components such as this are considered taboo.
The senior members in the kimono industry have said, "That's not suitable." But I don't believe I'm doing anything that is out of line. I feel that introducing concepts like these can lead to the evolution of kimonos. One can't keep doing things the traditional way when our surroundings look entirely different. Everything has changed, yet kimonos still exist as they did in ancient times. That's unnatural to me. What's more natural is to evolve and adapt, just like our culture.
Jun Hosokawa is the former editor-in-chief of a kimono magazine launched 60 years ago. He's a fan of Shito's kimonos.
The kimonos she makes are respectful of the rules. They're not overly eccentric, and they don't go about ignoring the theories of kimonos. And because of that, I thought there was something special there. She has a deep understanding of tradition in her creations. And you can tell by looking at her work that she's not someone who makes kimonos without knowing anything about them.
Shito has worn kimonos since she began Japanese dance lessons at age 3.
I couldn't really find any kimonos that I wanted to wear.
So she decided to design her own. Her kimono making process begins with fabric design. Lines drawn with a single black pen morph into boundary-defying kimono patterns.
In the kimono world, you're not supposed to stray from how things are done. You have to be on your best behavior. But I think it's much more fun when you stray. You need to free yourself. Let go of the idea that this is how things should be in order to create anything new.
Most of Shito's patterns have been conceived by the designer herself.
There are mistakes. There are small patterns and big ones. But I think that's what gives the fabric character and energy.
Then there's the actual kimono design. Shito determines how the diverse materials will be brought together.
When I draw, I picture people wearing the kimono. That's fun.
Her diagonal lines are especially bold. They would never appear on an old-fashioned kimono.
They stand out the most, so they're important.
She arranges the fabric, creating diagonals as she goes. The key is to pair pattern fabric with plain ones in similar hues. Once complete, these designs demand tremendous sewing skills to bring them to life. Shito need not worry, as she has a deft sewer in Akemi Mori. Mori is a veteran kimono dressmaker with a 45-year career. Haute couture kimonos are assembled and hand-sewn. Mori has been working with Shito for over 30 years, and she says the designer's lines are still a challenge to create.
Diagonal lines are so unconventional. When I first received the request to sew them on the kimonos, I thought, can I do this? There's no way. I should say no. I thought that all the time for many years.
In order to create Shito's ideal lines, up to 4 pieces of fabric are layered. Each one is about 4 millimeters thick. That is double the thickness for a regular kimono. A perfect union of skill and experience is needed to sew the complicated layers as one. The silk textiles vary in texture depending on their dye and weave.
There are issues like how tightly woven the fabric is and how much it stretches. You have to take that into consideration and balance it out. Where the 4 layers overlap, you have to sew so it's not pulling too tightly or is too loose. There's no rhyme or reason. It's just what the fingers know. She makes some challenging requests, and that fires me up because I hate to lose. She motivates me, so in that way, I'd say you've trained me.
Yes, in the beginning.
Even now.
But I wouldn't say those things to someone who wasn't capable. It means you have the skill.
Thank you.
Putting on a kimono is a complicated process. It starts with the undergarment and ends with the obi sash. Even Japanese people aren't able to put one on without first learning how. Shito has thought about how to make the process easier and more stylish. One way is by using her petite obi. Embedding a small sash with the same pattern as the kimono unifies the look. A petite obi is used in the back as well. The tsukeobi or pre-tied sash is folded and inserted into the back of the sash to give it a classic look. The bold combination of fabric, color, and patterns gives the kimono that distinct shito flair.
Things like this didn't exist in the kimono industry. Even if the sash doesn't match exactly, showing a little of the kimono fabric from beneath the sash creates the ultimate look from top to bottom.
To share how kimonos can become fashion items, the designer regularly hosts promotional events.
That was a design I hadn't seen before, and I was drawn to it immediately.
I like that you'll never be caught wearing the same kimono as someone else, and you can really stand out in the crowd. It's like a dress, but a more formal version. It's so much fun to wear.
I'm bored of regular kimonos, so it's been great to see Shito-san's pieces.
When I see people wearing and enjoying my kimonos, I feel so grateful to be a designer.
As you can see, Shito's kimonos are coordinated from head to toe. Her dream is to turn the kimono into a global fashion item. And she's now taking on a new challenge to make that dream come true.
Shito hopes kimonos can be worn easily, making them popular around the world.
Japanese people can wear Chinese dresses and traditional Vietnamese Ao Dai outfits. But people abroad aren't able to put on the kimono. And that absolutely frustrates me.
The frustration became the jumping-off point for Shito's easy-to-wear garments with kimono roots. This past May, she unveiled her line, Appare. The clothes fall somewhere between Japanese and Western styles. Shito hopes to reach a wider audience by making them easier to put on. This piece is worn over a shirt, then tied at the waist, and covered with a wider belt. Instant kimono feel. Vests and knit caps are layered on top. And knits and accessories are worn at a diagonal angle to complement the collar line. Shito is now over 60, and she continues to break new ground, but she has not been without her battles. At 37, she discovered she had breast cancer. The diagnosis came just as she opened a store in the middle of Tokyo and was preparing for a big fashion show. The designer was just hitting her stride.
I couldn't sleep. I thought if I fell asleep, I wouldn't open my eyes again.
The cancer was discovered early enough that a full recovery was possible. But her close encounter with death has deeply affected her life.
As long as you're alive, no matter how hard things get, it's better than death. So in a way, I was able to learn the ultimate lesson.
After beating cancer, Shito began to work tirelessly. She launched her brand Kado in Italy nearly 30 years ago, creating prototypes of her current kimono style. But she shut down the brand because of problems with foreign materials and sewing methods.
Even after 30 years, my feelings toward this kind of fashion haven't left me. They've only gotten stronger, in fact. And I want to now focus on garments that are made in Japan.
Her brand is also an introduction to the skilled artisans of Japan. The fabric is made at a factory in Shizuoka. This area is known as a production hub for cotton-weaved products. The fabric woven here is called sashiko-ori, which is often used to make judo uniforms. This factory has developed a thinner version with added texture for use in regular clothes. And Shito has further enhanced the fabric with a more distinct texture and unique feel.
It's difficult, technically, to make a fabric with just the right texture. Some of my designs have been made possible because the fabric was created.
The Shizuoka fabric is next sewn in the Tohoku region of Yamagata. This factory has some of Japan's greatest kimono making techniques. Sewing machines are used to stitch ready-made kimonos. Refined and detailed sewing techniques are maximized for Shito's brand.
The straight line is a cherished Japanese aesthetic, and the curvy line represents a Western one. We find the perfect blend and believe this is where we can best show our capabilities.
Also important to Shito's brand is her statement-making knitwear accessories. These are made at a factory in the top production region, Niigata. Here, lightweight knits made of fine threads have been developed in accordance with contemporary trends. Shito incorporates the subtle kimono element of layering with these feather-light knits.
To create something that's light, warm, and see-through like this takes skill.
Lightweight items that are knitted and sewn must be done with greater care than thicker fabrics. Otherwise, it will end up looking cheap.
Instead of using just one color, layering the fabrics adds a fashionable touch. Like with the orange peeking out from under the knit hat.
The efforts of Shito and her team of artisans have been infused into her brand, slated for release in the fall. The designer's goal is to expand kimonos to the rest of the world, and she is just getting started.
I want to live and die as a designer.
I want to live and die as a designer. Very powerful words. From Japan to the rest of the world, I really do hope more people will enjoy kimonos in the future. Next up is Tokyo Buzz. This spring, a new shop opened in Tokyo that sells a single fashion item. Can you guess what it is?